Pontiac, Michigan. I am a sculptor. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my background. In 1960, I started at Wayne State University in Detroit, Michigan. And then in 1965, I moved to New York City, lived in the East Village, and went to the Art Students League for 3 years. I had a scholarship for a year there. Then I had to leave New York City for health reasons. Then I went back to Detroit and then to the San Francisco Art Institute for a year. Then back to Detroit, and I had a studio in the Fourth Ice Building in downtown Detroit. Then I moved to Minneapolis, where I was there for 3 years, and I was apprenticed to a woodcarver from Greece. Finally, I moved back to Pontiac, Michigan. That's on the outer edge of the Detroit area, and I've been here ever since. In 1980, I went back to college at Wayne and completed my Bachelor of Arts degree with a major in humanities. Sculpture called Dancer that I've been working on for quite a while. The idea was derived from working with a dancer and drawing her while she was dancing. I did that for quite a while. Her name was Leslie Berg. And first of all, I did a couple of maquettes, smaller versions. Then I did a third size version. Then I saw a Degas sculpture show of his dance sculptures at the Detroit Institute of Arts, and that was inspirational. Then I began the full size. And the full size has a welded metal armature inside, and the styrofoam is taped around the welded metal armature. And then there's wire mesh around the armature, and then the clay that you see of the figure is modeled over that wire mesh. These over here on the wall are drawings that were done during the process. How they were done was a temporary armature was constructed out of the metal re-rod cut into sections. Then it was clamped together. And then I taped some styrofoam around the re-rod. And then I took photographs of the temporary armature from four different views. You see two sets there. And the point of it was to see if my drawing conception of the figure would work with the armature as I had constructed it there. So I drew over the armature the different views of the sculpture, and that was how those were done. This is a mold section that is part of the casting process. This sculpture is going to be cast in epoxy resin at this point. And this is one of 10 mold sections. It was done by taking silicon rubber, that's this orange stuff, and painting it over the sculpture. That was the first thing. It takes up all of the detail, Then a plastic mother mold, it's called, this stuff, is put over the rubber mold and it holds it in place. Then the mold section, it's from here to here, this mold section, the lower legs from the waist to the base, and includes the feet. The mold section is taken off, and then you have that to work with. The cast itself is done by impregnating fiberglass cloth with epoxy. Epoxy resin is a two-part solution that you mix together and you have 20 minutes before it hardens. And you mix the two parts together and then saturate the fiberglass cloth with the resin, and then when it hardens, that becomes the actual cast. Now that's just one section. You have to do that in 10 different sections. Then the cast is pulled out of the mold, and then there's the process of putting the pieces together, the cast sections together, to form the whole sculpture. And then it's painted or patinaed. I follow my working definition of great art, which goes accuracy, form, content, likeness, and character. Art is what I do. You can reach me by email.